Imagine.
Alex plays the Rams. David plays Malik. Ryan, you're gonna be playing Malik if Alex doesn't win.
I know, bro. I'm mad. That's what I've been mad about. I was afraid.
I'll play the other side of the bracket.
If Manny wins,
What? I don't want to upgrade, bro.
Justin Reed, he finally hit 85,
oh,
so I can actually use
Oh my goodness,
this.
No. Not that dude, bro.
Yo, Ryan, now you got 97 speed.
That's what it was. I knew he had something.
But.
Dexter Lawrence got an upgrade, too. Hey, Manny's gonna be scared when he sees my defensive line. Chris Jones got an upgrade.
You scaring these nuts in your mouth, bro.
Wait, Manny, what's your YouTube name?
It's just my name, Manny Flores. I sent the leak, though.
Showing up.
I know. Hey, Chris Jones got plus one speed.
Hey.
Well, I'm hyped for this game, for sure. My players got uploaded.
See ya. Is the stream working?
Yeah, it's working.
Okay.
I'm just trying to figure out if I need to have my eyes to the camera for a minute.
Huh? Okay, I'm sending you an invite. Jit.
Alright, I'm sending you the invite, man.
Oh, so you're sending me it?
I think if we blowed it at the same time, that would just blow us in.
Oh, okay.
90 versus 91, let's get it.
Man.
What playbook are you using? Green Bay?
No. How do you already have that set? My throwback uniforms suck. Yeah. Oh, what? I was gonna pick green, bro.
We're gray.
Oh yeah, they're gray uniforms.
Yeah, they're gray uniforms.
Is it this one? Oh, yeah. I wanna see that game, bro.
Oh, yeah. David gonna get smacked, but his stream's working out.
I'm black, dude. I don't know. Tom.
Well, you folks at home,
damn.
The evidence, snow, and supposedly a few inches yet
Lincoln
to fall
Financial
Lincoln
Field.
Financial Field in Philadelphia.
It's hot in this room.
Between the Seattle Seahawks and the Philadelphia Eagles.
It's like a light snow or something now.
Is
that the end zone? Oh! Pick it off! Hilarious, bro. Smarty's nuts in your mouth, bro. You think you're fucking funny, bro. Don't quit, bro. Dude, what? Did you go to like depth chart or something? I thought it was gray. Dude, I thought I picked the gray one, bro. I swear, man. It showed up gray on my screen. He literally go to the stream, dude. And check the lead. He like green on my screen. I mean, not green. Face mask, bro? Come on. Oh. Oh my fucking god. Shut the fuck up, bro. Stop bitching, bro. Can't you go like this or something, bro? Jesus, man. I'm bitching. You go to fucking options. Stop putting these balls in there, bitch. But you don't. No, he's catching that, bro. Take the three. Man. I think that's the exact right way to do it. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll run for it with Akers. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26.
Well, that's what's called being aggressive right there. But I don't know that it's reckless. I think it's much more of a message. Hey, defense, I believe in you in case we don't get it. Trying to let him know he believes in him as well.
I like it. Your first drive of the game in plus territory. Be aggressive. They look to throw now on first down.
It's intercepted. Why is it so slow? God. I wasn't even using him, bro. How bitching. God. Game starting controversies, bruh. Oh my lord. This is so slow. Yes. He is not that slow without the snow. No way, bro. I'm yanked. First down. Oh my god. I'm going for this shit.
He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down.
Manny J run the ball at us this morning.
What?
He can't stop you.
Can you fucking stop commenting, fucking nerd? Bro. so slow, bro. This ain't happening in a real snow game. What the hell just happened? So slow, dude. God. Your dude fat as hell. Tackle him, bro. Oh. Tackle him, bro. This man is spelling Eagles or something. Yeah, spelling it out. Two, bro. Really? I want these nuts, bro. Yeah! You don't have any pauses left, I don't think. See, yeah. Yeah! Oh, fine. Pause it for you. Yeah, but like, do an offense, do an offense. No, when you're on offense. I'm not running it, bro. Bro, I'm not running. How am I gay, bro? Is he no... I don't get anything from that, bro. Fucking bitch ass man. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Run faster, bro. Yes, P.I., P.I., P.I. Yes, he did, bro. Yes, he did. He did. He did. He did, bro. He did. P.I., bro. That's definitely P.I., you fucking genius. That's P.I. What are you talking about? What? This is not a thrown game for me, man. That's what I'm saying, Alex.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Flush to his right.
Oh. Well, I thought my fucking dude would do something. Fat fuck, man! Fucking fatty, bro. Lagging for her. So much because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's what are you doing, bro? Sometimes we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflects the other side, and then things really go from there. That's the thing for me to talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate.
Your team's, yes. Your team is. Are you serious? Can you fucking get out of the screen, bro? Auden Tate or whatever. I don't know his name is.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around the bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because
oh my god, oh my god, oh my god.
You can break out or you can break in.
Obviously, bro. Auden Tate, my man. I don't even know who it is. I don't know. I don't know. Actually, it's not my team, bro. She's 7'4". I don't know who. Oh my God. Oh line, bro. What are you doing? You're selling the game, bro. Selling, bro. Oh my! Did you know? Did you?
A 9-yard touchdown there. And the Seahawks able to make this a close game again.
Oh my god. Dude. Why did it go so quick? Doesn't usually go that quick. I've played with him before. He doesn't usually miss that. I don't know why. I guess, man. Yeah.
This one taken just inside the 10. Oh, good looking return set up here. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 30.
Dude. Oh. Go to coaching. Depth chart. Yeah. Did you put him in, bruh? God. Jeez.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And for them, it's down their last go around. Obviously, they'll be
able to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you
Why would you switch teams because of that? So bad, bro. Is it your neighborhood right now? You're just Carlos too. And shit.
Look here for the Seahawks on third down. They'll drop to throw. And here's Jones. He's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10. Down at the 33. Time to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Oh my god, I'm fucking.
He's gonna have the hook up here to Chase.
Tackle him, man.
Come on, Manny, let's go.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
Down he goes at the 10 with a solid pickup of 8. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. He'll look to throw. They can't hear it's complete. And the Eagles are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the 1. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside.
Lock up, boy.
Single, but I don't think he got the surge behind center. No, he's going to be kept out of the end zone. They'll look to run with Akers. Akers punching it in from a yard away. And the Eagles.
Let's go, man.
Everybody in the stadium knew what they were going to do right there, CD. 3 tight ends on the field, all that extra bulk, and they run it in. And
you saw with that all that extra bulk, and they run it in. Come on, man. You fuck off with that shit. Annoying ass bitch.
Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders.
What?
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10.
That's a waste. No gain, bro. It's not a fucking sack.
That's a nice job defensively to make sure everyone was accounted for, because ordinarily you pick up the guys downfield and sometimes you forget about the running back. In this case, they did not.
What? Yes, I know. What? My ass. Down, please. Give me that. No way.
They do get 9, but it leads to 4th down.
And he's chosen. If you give it to me in this territory, we will have receivers on the field.
Come on, man. This team sucks, bro.
Curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out, and the Eagles are going to take over in great field position.
I get the ball half right.
First and 10 now from the 33.
Okay. Sold, bro.
Throwing here to start the drive. We'll dump this off to Akers.
Dude. Come on.
There's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. And he'll fight his way down to the 12. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Now that's the mouth of a man that just made that stop, isn't it?
What up, JJ Watt?
This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions. And here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield. He was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time.
force that incompletion. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
I thought they might take a shot down the field, but instead they ran a little drag route there. I think they were hoping he could catch it and run away from the defender. But a really good job keeping the play in front of them, and they force a fourth down.
And we're going to get a timeout.
Field goal.
2 seconds remaining in the second quarter.
Okay, man. Okay. There's an answer talking for you, bro. Not for me. No way. How's he wide open, bro? What my defense doing, man?
Drive the Seahawks offense. And Charles, yeah, that had to be an interesting locker room at halftime. This is a team that's had so much success this year. Haven't really had to deal with a lot of adversity at halftime.
I'm going to speak to that. Respectfully, bro.
Into that interesting locker room, you're just wondering, how are they handling that bit of adversity that they're seeing right now?
Oh, that's a big, bro. You fucking black dude? God. What are you black for then? Come on, man. Why didn't I not throw there?
And he'll just get rid of it. Well, defensively, they haven't let him just
He was kind of open, but... Yes, he's tough, bro. Tough. Dude. Nah, bro. Just, like, do your, like, 0% try on again, man. For the culture. Oh, my God. Come on, Hunt. Do something, you black dude. Probably not fumbled yet. I think that's a big pickup for a first down. I don't even know. I mean, yeah, you did. You did fumble. You did fumble, though. I guess. On that, my ass. And it comes on a gain of 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Excuse me. They run again with Hunt. No way. I'm gonna fucking... Fuck. Right. Dude. What? Oh. And hopefully onto the Super Bowl. And that return for a touchdown certainly helps that cause. And he's got it. So the try for two successful. And that bumps their lead up even further. Bro, that's bullshit, dude. I don't. This game sucks, bro. Is it Kareem Hunt, bro? You're so black. You get fucking bullied by another black dude, bro. Fuck off, man. How you gonna let a grown man bitch you like that, dude? Gonna run the ball the whole game now. Yeah, but like, I don't know. Let me get the ball back, bro. Catch a ball. Come on, brick ass bitch. Brick hands, man. Catch better than you with fucking no hands, bro.
Should have
fucking
been
amputated hands, bitch. Fuck off. How's that? That's not a first down, bro. How's that first down?
On third down.
just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. And this is going to be incomplete.
The one with the dive look that time on defense just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
They'll look to throw again. The left side completion to Jones. And now this is going to depend on the spot. And they say he's just short. The Eagles unable to convert there on 4th. And the Seahawks are going to take over the football. They'll come out throwing here on 1st down. Eluding the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. I kind of got to give him credit. Another incompletion there, yes, but he's still trying to make plays outside the pocket.
Yeah, he's been hemmed in for much of the game. How about him getting outside there? And that's what you want to see from your quarterback. He's not giving up on this game, so every other player on the field has to say to himself, I can't give up either.
And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. The Seahawks on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 10.
Bro, I did. Oh my god.
Now back to throw. And he will find Ridley on the left side. And a good tackle there right around the 30 stops him short of the 1st down.
Oh, what? Catch a ball, man.
Start matching each other's movements.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. That's to his running back, complete.
I'm going to do some things right there.
Just a yard or two shy of the 40. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 41.
What? What the hell was that, bro?
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Back to throw again. He's going to dump this off to his running back, Hunt. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with 3rd and 9 looming.
So get the ball down to the Eagles 19.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He'll get this one underneath to Hunt. Touchdown, Seahawks! Kareem Hunt from 19 yards away. And the Seahawks get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this 4th quarter deficit. This time, the extra point up and good. Cut the lead back down to 21. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded right around the 8. Oh, good return up past the 30.
Philly offense set to go. And you'd have to say they have done what they set out to do with this wild card round. It won't get easier from here, of course, but they'll certainly have some momentum built up for when they hit the road in the divisional round next weekend. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. As they set up to throw. Looking downfield for Jones.
What?
Inside the 10. Deep in Seattle territory. A big play there for Philly. They'll run here with Akers. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. He'll look to throw.
I mean, wide open.
That's Terry McLaurin there to make the grab. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. But look, this is a team, Charles. They faced adversity all year long. They had a fighting claw to win that division. But they're putting it all together here in the wild card game.
Feels like a statement, doesn't it? An absolute statement game. A message to the top seeds. Overlook is a draw. This is something that Pete Carroll should be pretty well familiar with. Remember when he told Jim Harbaugh after losing a bowl game, Harbaugh over too late against him? Hey, what's your deal? It's the same situation here. Now, I'd kick the extra point, but I am reminded that plenty of coaches feel like it's not their job to worry about the other team. It's their job to worry about their own team. You have to stop us.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They are most likely staring at a cold end to their season here in this wild card round. Nothing has gone right so far, and they are, to be frank, in desperation mode now as they begin with a first and 10. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Definitely desperation time. This just looks like, hey, throw it down there, hoping your guy can make a play.
You want him to make a play, but if not, maybe you get a pass interference call. And you know in the NFL, that's a spot foul. You get all that yardage. That would be a big play.
They'll run with Hunt on second down. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, and you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure on the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth. Here's Matt Hawk now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. They can't bring him down. Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him as it is. It'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Eagles will have great starting field position here as they take over. Now it looks like he'll throw here. Devontae Parker complete. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Steps away to his left. He's going to let this go.
You...
back of the end zone. And this will be touchdown.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it to the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way by taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to the ball.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. next drive, the Seahawks offense. And at this point, maybe you say, you know, it was a good effort really just to make the playoffs. They couldn't win their division but did earn a wild card berth. It does appear, however, that their season is just a few minutes away from ending in one-and-done fashion. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Second and eight. They'll run again with Hunt. And not a whole lot doing there, so he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. They follow up a gain of two with a gain of one that time.
Yeah.